I'm gonna try to do this in one attempt. I'm really showing all the apps I use for this. First thing you want to do is go get you a background. You can use Pinterest or Google or anything. Nice and cute backgrounds that you want to use for your intro. And then you want to go to InShot, and then go to, you could have just went to photo, because we're going to get a photo, because the background is a photo, not a video. You see me, I'm kind of messing up right here. But it's just going to go to photo, and then you're going to go to that background that you picked. That's the background that I did pick. Then you're going to actually go to Canvas, and then you're going to zoom that background in, okay? So zoom it in all the way to your liking, or you can zoom it out, but I zoomed mine in, okay? Okay, so this is gonna be our first background for the intro. Okay. So now what we're gonna do is go cut out all our pictures that we're gonna use. So basically, I cut my pictures out on PicsArt. So what you're about to see me do is just cut out all the pictures that I'm gonna use first. So you're gonna go to PicsArt, pick the picture that you want. Then at the bottom, you're gonna go to the cutout. Then you're just gonna click on the little body looking head thingy, and it should cut your whole body out. Of course, you'll have to go fix it up a little, you know, to your liking, so it can look as clean as possible. So I pretty much did this already. For the sake of this video, I didn't quite, you know, do it how I did when I made my intro, but I already made my intro. I was just doing this video over, just showing you guys how to clean it up and everything. But of course, I'll be more precise how I was in my actual video. I'm not actually going to save this photo for real, because like I said, I already saved it. I already have this saved. I'm just showing you guys the process. Okay, so I find it easier when you just go ahead and cut out all the photos that you're going to use first, instead of going back and forth to each app. So I'm just an organized person. I'm just going to do what I got to do in this app, so I ain't got to come back. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So I'm going to cut out all my pictures. And I'm sorry, y'all, if y'all hit a game in the back of my boyfriend. Yes, playing a game. Yes. Usual. Oh my god, it's harder than I thought, because I'm actually moving so slow than I want to talk. So it's like, I don't know, you guys, just bear with me. Okay, so once I get all those photos cut out, I'm gonna go back to InShot, and then I'm gonna start inserting those photos how I want them to come in. So you're gonna go to the same thing, photo, and then I'm just gonna add the first photo. Oop, then I'm gonna move it to the side, because that's where I want it to be. However you're gonna do yours, that's how you can do it. And another photo on another side. Like I said, I'm so organized, y'all. I want everything to be balanced. I can't deal with the unbalancedness. Okay. So right now I'm just playing with animations, how I want it to come in. In order to animate on this app, you just double tap it. And then you can animate it any way you want. So as you see right now, I am playing with animations. So after I do that, I'm basically about to go ahead and do my wording. I forgot to go ahead and go in PicsArt. When you go in PicsArt, you want to scroll all the way to the bottom to the transparent background and just save the background. Then you want to go in Fonto and open that background that you saved from PicsArt. Basically, it's a transparent. Go ahead and put Kylan TV. The font I used, I believe, was you'll see the font I used. That's the font I used for my capital, my big wording. I really love that font. I'm so mad I can't remember. So I used that, and then I went ahead and added a quick shadow. So to do that, I went to style, and then I pressed the fourth A at the bottom to give me like a bold shadow type look. You know. If you know, you know. Okay, so when I went ahead and did that, I wanted to have another cute little Kylan written like right above it in pink. So I went ahead and did that, and the font I used was actually a font that I downloaded. I believe it's called, I forget what it's called, y'all. Like, it's called English something, y'all, but it's a very cute cursive. Hopefully you can see it from the screen recording. I forgot. Then I turned it pink, and then I'm just gonna go ahead and add it to that. Yeah. So once I went ahead and did all that, placed it how I want it, then I'm just gonna go save it. When you save it, make sure that you save it as a PNG, you guys. So when you save it as a PNG, that way when you put it up in InShot, the background will be gone, okay? Okay. So while I was right here, I went ahead and just did all the wording that I want on my intro. Like I said, I'm a very organized person. Instead of going back and forth, I just went ahead and typed out everything that I know I'm going to want on my intro. I know I'm going to want subscribe. I know I'm going to want welcome to my channel. And I know I'm going to want vlogs, reactions, and lifestyle. So just bear with me while I just show y'all basically how I did that. It's really repetitive, you guys. And it's so easy, so easy. Just follow along. I promise you, I got you. I got you, sis. And I really hope that this is helpful. I try to make it as helpful as I can. Of course, I'm not a graphic designer at all. I learned on my own, and I just want to teach you guys so you guys could make your own intros instead of having to pay people. Because, you know, times is hard. You know, you can make... Listen, I'm going to show you the easy way, and it's still going to be cute, period. Oh my God, I can't spell. What's going on? Okay, so once I'm done with all the wording, I'm just gonna go back in InShot and start to input some of the phrases, I guess you can say that. Some of the things I just typed in Funto, I'm just gonna go on InShot and start to insert them. First thing I'm gonna insert is my name, Kylan TV, and of course I want that big and bold front and center, cause stop playing. And I'm gonna go ahead and put an animation on that as well. As you see right now, I am playing with the animations, how I want it to come in and go out. Okay, you see, I'm liking how that's going. I'm liking how that is, you know? You know, yeah, I like that. Okay, so I went ahead and I added my third photo that I wanted on the first background. I'm only gonna put three photos here. And of course, I want that third photo to actually slide up and on top of the wording as well. So you're gonna see me work that around so that I can get that third photo to come in exactly how I want it to. Yes, that's how I want it to come. I want it to come up and then go up. That's perfect. Actually, no, I want it to come up and then go to the side. Yeah, that's perfect. I want those to go actually down. So I want those to come in, slide in, and then go down. Basically what you see me doing is I'm getting my animations together just so it won't look sloppy and it'll just look in place, you guys. I'm really pretty much not gonna explain every single thing I did because I'm pretty sure y'all can see what's going on. And I don't wanna seem, you know, crazy, you know, cause y'all know what's going on. So I'm gonna talk when needed. Like I said, this is my first time doing a video like this, so I'm actually praying that it's helpful, that I'm not just rambling, you know? So pretty much that's perfect for the first part of my intro. That's exactly how I wanted the first part of my intro to be. So you see, I'm just a little fixing it up, spiffing it. I'm not really gonna add anything else on the first part. It's pretty much gonna be like this, but I'm just fixing it up right now, you guys. I'm not changing anything right now. I'm just basically making sure it comes in and goes out in a way that doesn't make it look sloppy, because I hate sloppy stuff. Not joking, I hate it. I'm a perfectionist, organized. I want it to be organized. Okay, so you guys, right now what I'm about to do is add my second part of my intro. So what I did is the same thing as the first time. I got my second background. So this is another background. I got this background off Google. I think it's perfect. I went ahead and pressed Canvas and zoomed that in. And now we're about to start, you know, adding animations and words and photos on it, you know. Of course, we want everything to look in sync. Of course, I know you're going to do that on your own. You're a perfectionist just like me. So like I said, just for video purposes, I'm not sure y'all, but this video I tried to make it look as, you know, organized as possible from when I first made my intro. But of course, for this video, I was a little lazy, you guys. So I went ahead and I added one of those phrases that I typed in Fonto, which is welcome to my channel. I do want that to pop up at the top of the second background. So I went ahead and put that up there. And I also added an animation so it can just be like it slide in from the first background. Yeah, I know, too much. Just bear with me, you guys. So I'm about to go ahead and add my last photo that I'm gonna have on my intro. So that photo will be on the second background. So it will be this one. So right now I'm just playing with the animations. Actually, no, I don't know what I'm doing, y'all. Okay, so I'm just adding all my words as well. I'm adding the words where I want them to be. I want the welcome to my channel at the top and the subscribe at the bottom. Of course, I want the welcome to my channel and the subscribe to come in at the same time in sync. So in order to do that, of course, you just want to make sure that they're starting at the same and ending at the same at the bottom. If you can tell, I'm really sliding the cursor that goes to each video. So you just want to make sure they're the same length. And what I did is I went ahead and I added the phone. I didn't actually screen record how I got the phone, but all you got to type in is iPhone transparent, iPhone background transparent on Google, and you can find one easily. And then I went ahead and I screenshotted my Instagram just because I want my social in my intro as well. So screenshot your Instagram. Then I added my Instagram inside the phone, basically like, you know, it's the phone with my Instagram. And you guys, I'm such a perfectionist. Like, I wanted these two to slide in exactly at the same time because, you feel me, how your screen gonna slide in after the phone, you know? I don't want to be that sloppy. So you guys, it kind of took me a while to get it perfect. But for the sake of this video, I didn't try to just be so picky about it. But when I really made my intro for real, y'all, it took me forever because I wasn't finna play with this. I wasn't finna let this stop playing. You could see me being a little picky about it right now, but I just said forget it. Okay, so these are the last words that I'm gonna add to my intro, and I want those in the middle. I want those in the middle, and I'm actually gonna add a little loop animation to those. I slowed it down for this video. In my real intro that I made, I didn't slow it down. I regret not slowing it down. I think it looks better when it's slowed down like that instead of moving really fast. But it's okay because I already got my intro made and I love my intro. So I'm basically just playing around, making sure everything looks in sync and together. Sake of this video, you're gonna see me going back to the beginning a lot just so I can make sure everything is looking organized, you guys. I can't stress this enough. Like, I'm my biggest critic. Like, I am literally my biggest critic. I went to the beginning of this video so many times to make sure that everything is going exactly how I want it, you know. And did y'all see how just organized that look? I loved it. See, the first part is perfect as of right now. First part perfect. Now I'm just trying to get it for like the first and the second part, they transition together perfectly.
And I want those words to actually be on top of my photo. In order to do that, all you have to do is click on the words there at the bottom. Whichever layer that you click is the layer that's going to be on top. It's literally that easy. So whichever layer you want on top, just click it, click it, click it. Make sure that y'all comment below how I'm doing, because I really feel like for my first time doing a video, a voiceover like this, I'm all over the place. I'm trying not to be all over the place, you guys. So comment down below what you guys think and any tips and tricks that you have, you know, because I think I can do this. I just need y'all help, you know? You know? Oh, that looked perfect. That looked in sync to me. Y'all see exactly what I'm doing at the bottom of the screen. That's why I'm really not too much pinpointing everything that I'm doing, because you guys clearly can see what I'm doing and I don't want to be irritating. I don't want to be irritating. So yeah, I promise I'll get better at this, you guys. I promise. I'm gonna tap the words so they can be in front of the phone. Okay, I'm just doing a run through, making sure I like it. Let's see. Okay, I think that's good. It's one more step that I do. After I saved this one, this is the first, I did the first and the second step in InShot. And the third step, I do in a different app. So once I'm done with this part, I'm obviously going to go to the second app to do the third step. So because I am going to a different app, you're going to see me stretch the background a little bit longer so that when I do go into that second app, the background can be the same. You see how it's just the background, but everything's gone. I did that on purpose. So when I go to the next app, things that I put on it from the next app can be on that same background. So once I go ahead and get that how I want it, I'm gonna go ahead and save that. Make sure you save it at the highest pixels and everything possible, just so it can look good. So the second app I'm gonna go into is Video Leap. So this is basically where I'm gonna add my videos in on my intro. Y'all, we not doing pro, no, no, no. Because we not doing pro, because I'm cheap and I ain't wanna pay, we ain't doing pro. It's like two extra steps that we gotta do, but it's cool though. You know, we gotta save that coin. So what you're gonna do is go add that video in. And what we're finna do is just add our videos at the end. So I'm doing a run through. Okay. So far, so good. Okay, so right here is where I'm about to add a few videos of myself. I had to do it in this app because InShot, you couldn't actually add videos in. So what I'm going to do is I'm about to add the phone, and then I'm going to add the video that I want. Oh, that's the wrong phone, y'all. Disregard that. Delete. Hold up. The phone. And then... Put the phone where you want it. I want three videos of myself in a phone. If you only want one, of course, you don't have to do this step two more times. And if you pay for pro, of course, you don't got to do this step two more times. You can overlap it. But since I'm cheap, you're going to have to do it two more times. So basically, what I'm going to do is position the phone how I like it, make it come in when I like it, and add the video that I want to go inside of it. And then I'm going to do this two more times. Well, I'm going to do this, and then I'm going to save it, and then bring the video back in, then do it again, save it, bring the video back in, then do it again, then save it, and then we're done. That's because I want three videos, though, you guys. Basically, what I'm doing right now is I'm lining the video and the phone up, basically, so it could look like the video is playing inside the phone. That simple. I want it to come in and leave together. Okay, so this is where you're about to see me save it. But I didn't actually save it for you guys because I already have that saved. So save it. Then I'm going to delete everything that I have so that I can add the saved video back in so we can add the second video in. Like I did mention, of course, if you do buy the Pro, Video Leap Pro, you won't have to do this. You can just do all this in one step. But, you know, I found a way around it. Period. So you're going to add that video in. I want another video of myself on the other side and then another on the other side. Like I told y'all, I gotta have everything organized. So I had to do this, you guys. I just could not keep that one phone in the middle. I had to add two more. So basically it's the same steps as before. Just add the phone, add the video, make sure it's coming in and leaving together, make sure it's in sync, and that's it. Y'all, right now I'm just making sure that the phones come in at the same time because I don't want to look in a little ghetto. One phone come in, then another phone come in, 3 seconds later, that's ghetto, you guys. Whenever I do get this part right, as you can see, I'm basically just trying to line it up, make sure that it look right. What I'm going to do is go ahead and save this video again. Then I'm going to bring the video back into Video Leap. Then I'm going to put the third video in, which is that's the third and the last video. So I promise y'all will not have to see this step again. I promise you, after I put the third video in, that's it. That's all. It's one more step we have to do, and that one is easy. I promise. Gonna insert that phone again, then insert my third video, try to make it line up correctly so that it could look right, so it could look like all three phones are coming in and leaving out together, and so that it can look like those videos are playing from out of those phones like a real phone, basically. And I do just want to say thank you guys for watching this video because we're really pretty much almost at the end. It's only one more step after this. So I do want to just thank you guys for watching this video. Thank you guys for tuning in and thank you guys for supporting me. Like I said, this is my first time doing this video. So please don't be too crucial in the comments. You know how y'all be. You know, don't be too crucial, you guys. But I would like feedback because I would like to help anyone that's looking to start a channel and don't want to pay people to do that. You guys don't want to pay people to do what you guys could do on your own, you know, because everything with my channel, I did it on my own, literally. I edit, I do everything on my own. So if you need help with anything, just comment down below and I'll definitely make a video about it. Final run through, let's see. What you guys think? Okay, I think that was perfect. So I'm gonna go ahead and save it. Then after I get that saved, what I'm gonna do is go into iMovie so that I can add my, oh y'all, look at my man, look at bae. Hey bae. Oh my god. So what I'm gonna do now, sometimes I'm gonna add movie so that I could just add my music. I actually added my music on my MacBook. I didn't use it on my phone. You could do it on your phone. There's a specific way I add music to my videos from my phone. If you want to see that in a different video, I'll be happy to help you guys with that. Just comment that below if you'd like to see that. Other than that, I do use my MacBook because it's easier on the MacBook. But there is a way you can do it on your phone if you don't have music saved on your phone. You know I found a way around everything. Y'all know me. But yeah, y'all, that's pretty much it. That's pretty much all. After I add the music, I'm done with my intro. Yay. So yay. Thank you guys for watching this video. Thank you guys for tuning in. Like I said, If you have any tips and tricks for me, make sure you comment that below. And I do want to just say I love you guys. And make sure if you have not yet, you go ahead and subscribe to your girl channel. Period.